Hello friends, I'm Santanam from Smart Leaders IAS. In this video, we will try to understand the differences between Android and iOS. Before we begin to start comparing the two operating systems, let's just try to understand what an operating system is. You see, we humans, we speak different languages across different parts of the world. This is not necessarily something that a machine can understand. A machine talks only using binary languages. An operating system comes into picture now. An operating system is one which helps us interact with the computer and get things done for us. The job of an operating system is to ensure that the hardware and the software is usable for the end customer. And Android and iOS are two such operating systems. Now let us try to understand what other operating systems are there. There are so many operating systems which have come to existence throughout the past two decades, and Android and iOS are just two of them. Now, why are we actually trying to look at only Android and iOS instead of focusing on so many other operating systems as well? Well, because Android and iOS hold the two largest market share in mobile operating systems. So we want to try to understand more about them and try to know which is better and which is not. So how different are they? Let us first try to understand their origin stories. T-Mobile Sidekick was one of the earliest smartphones, and it was very successful when it was released. And one of the creators of this T-Mobile decides to start his own company called Android. And he goes to Google to get some support from them. And Google instead sees potential in their idea and decides to buy them completely. That's how Google acquired Android and decides to invest so much money into smartphone business. And simultaneously, while this was going on, Apple had just released its first iPod. And Steve Jobs was actually very wary of smartphones because he thought that smartphones can actually kill his iPod. So he also wanted to enter the smartphone market, and he was very aggressively going for acquisitions and technology development in the smartphone area. And finally, on June 29, 2007, the first iPhone was born. And just a couple of months later, on November 5th, 2007, Android was born. While these two came into existence almost around the same time, there are certain differences between them. Now let's try to break them down. Let's see the making first. Android is actually Linux based and it is open source. iOS, on the other hand, is based on Objective-C and it is a proprietary software. Since Android is open sourced, it is open for customization, which means that Android can actually give its stock Android OS to OEMs, also known as original equipment manufacturers, who can actually tinker with the software and create services as per their expectations, as per their desires. iOS, on the other hand, is very tightly coupled and it is a proprietary software, and Apple does not let anybody to tinker with it. While this customization option seems to give Android an edge over iOS, there is one little problem. Because it allows other OEMs to tinker with its OS, there could be some instability. On the other hand, iOS has proved to be very stable. One of the key factors in differentiating between Apple's iOS and Google's Android is the software-hardware coupling, where in iOS, we have this system called tight coupling of software and hardware, where the software is decided based on the hardware and the hardware is decided based on the software. So they have a specific purpose in mind while creating the iPhone, and that's what they're going to cater to. So there is not going to be much changes in different models of iPhones. On the other hand, Android doesn't do that. Android, since it gives its OS to other manufacturers, they themselves tinker with it and they create their own hardwares, which means that the same Android version is going to support different hardware components across different mobiles. So this looks like a flexibility option given by Android to users, but that's not necessarily the case, because if Apple decides to release an update on iOS, then almost all users get the updates at the same time. When Android releases its updates, the original handset makers should also have to get that update and make the changes to release it for their own customers, which is going to ensure that there is some delay in people receiving Android updates than on iOS updates. One of the most important reasons why we use mobile is to actually use the mobile applications. And in that case, if you look at the applications provided by iPhone and the applications provided by Android, they are more or less similar, but there is a difference in the way how they handle it. iOS, for instance, does not allow any third-party mobile app to be downloaded into iPhone. It allows only the apps present inside its mobile app store to be downloaded into an iPhone. Android, on the other hand, gives a lot of flexibility to users, so it lets people to actually download mobile applications even if it is outside its Play Store. And it is precisely because of this reason that there are some stability issues with respect to Android, but not so much when it comes to iOS. While Apple services and Google services have seamless integration amongst themselves, there is a concept called shattered uniformity, which applies precisely to Android. And this is because while the crux of the OS remains the same for Android across all its devices, there are still certain changes brought about by the handset makers in each of their models. On the other hand, iOS has tight coupling, and across its devices, all its services and all its features remain the same. So for both of them, there is seamless integration across all its services. And this is possible because they are both integrated by cloud. One of the important concerns for any smartphone user is security. When we compare the security of Android and iOS, iOS actually fares a little better. This is because Android is a little relaxed when it comes to allowing the applications to get installed in its operating systems. iOS, on the other hand, has very tight security controls over the apps that gets downloaded in its device. Now that we have seen the origin stories, the different features of Android and iOS, there are two specific features which actually matter the most, especially to Indian users, and they are battery and cost. When it comes to battery, Android usually gives a large battery capacity, and this is to improve their user experience and just to enable the users to use their mobile phones for a longer period. iOS, on the other hand, usually gives a smaller battery size, but the device itself has proven to be very energy efficient. So they both fare pretty much on the same level. And finally, the cost. While Android devices are available for cheaper prices, iOS caters exclusively to the high-end category, and it makes it a very difficult purchase for an average Indian. So to conclude, which one is better, Android or iOS? Well, it depends. First of all, we have to understand that there has been a gradual convergence of services that is being provided by both the operating systems. In an increasingly app-driven world and an app-dependent mobile environment, the OS takes a backseat, so the divisions between Google and Apple is not necessarily significant. At the end of the day, what matters the most is deciding the right device for you. It should conform to your budget, and it should have the features which you need the most. Thank you for watching this video. To watch more such videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.